Hello, this is Matthias Möhl for mamoworld.com and welcome to the first class of our Expressions course for After Effects. Expressions is a very powerful and probably one of the most complex features of After Effects. Many people get started with expressions by cutting and pasting expressions they found somewhere online. And in general, this can be very useful, but it has one big drawback. As long as you don't understand how expressions really work, you're not able to adjust those expressions to your needs. Therefore, with this course, I want to take your expression skills to the next level and explain how expressions really work, how you write your own expressions or modify existing ones. We start with the very basics and then get to more and more advanced topics step by step. Today, I want to give you an overview of what expressions actually are, what you can, and also what you cannot do with them. Let's say we want to rotate the wheels of this car here. I already keyframed the rotation of the first wheel, and now we want to animate the second wheel in exactly the same way. Of course, you could copy the keyframes, but whenever we change the animation of the first wheel, we would also need to update the second one too. So instead, we'll use expressions to link the rotation of the second wheel to the rotation of the first one. To do this, we click the keyframing stopwatch while having the Alt or Option key pressed. Now this text box here appears, where we can enter the expression. Instead of entering the expression's code manually, we use the pickwhip symbol here, which generates link expressions. So we make sure the entire text is still selected and drag the pickwhip to the property that we want to link to. Now the expression's code has been replaced by some code saying, please link me to the rotation of this other wheel. If we move the current time indicator, you can see that both wheels are rotating now. The red color on the value indicates that the value is generated with an expression and not with keyframes. And if we change the rotation of the other wheel, the value generated by the expression also updates accordingly. So in general, expressions are like little formulas or little computer programs that compute the value of a property. Those formulas can become very complex, but don't panic. Like the pickwhip, there are many tricks and tools that help you to write those expressions. Let's take a quick look at a very complex expression, such that you get an impression how powerful they can be. This time I want to generate the expression with our extension iExpressions. iExpressions is a tool that contains more than 120 ready-to-use expressions, and each of them comes with an intuitive user interface. So there's no need to touch the actual expressions code. The physics section contains a lot of pretty advanced expressions. A real highlight is the automatic walk cycle that you can use for characters rigged with Dewey tools, for example. But this time we want to use the throw2D iExpression. Using the throw2D is surprisingly simple. We just need to enter a ground height, in this case 830, which is the position of this ball when it is located at the ground, and then apply it to the layer. If we now move the ball up, you can see that it falls and bounces on the ground. But it gets better. We can also keyframe a throw. So with those two keyframes, we move the ball in this direction. As you can see, like magic, the expression continues this movement and calculates a motion path based on true physics. This simulation is hundreds of lines of code long and probably one of the most complex expressions I've ever written. But still, it's so fast that it updates in real time. So you can see that from simple links to advanced physics simulations, you can do a lot with expressions. But there are also a lot of things that you cannot do with expressions, and it's very important to be aware of those limitations. So, the general idea is that an expression is an alternative to keyframes. A keyframe is just a simple number, and by adding more and more keyframes, you can describe how a property evolves over time. Compared to that, an expression is a formula that tells After Effects how to compute the value for each frame of the composition. So this means, if you apply an expression to the position of a layer, then all it can do is to animate the position of this layer. The expression of this position cannot modify any other properties or, say, duplicate a layer or execute a menu command or import or replace some footage. In a nutshell, with expressions you can only control things that can be keyframed. So you cannot turn the eyeball of a layer on or off with expressions, because the eyeball cannot be keyframed. But you can apply an expression to the opacity of a layer, and then let the expression set the opacity to 0 or 100 to make the layer appear or disappear. In other words, with expressions you can do only things that you could also do with keyframes, with the only difference that with an expression it is usually much faster and more automated. Of course, any motion path you generate with a throw2D iExpression can also be animated by hand with keyframes. And instead of linking one wheel of this car to the other one, you could keyframe both. But with expressions, you can do the same so much faster and automate aspects of your project. But all automation you can do with expressions is about avoiding manual keyframing, because this is all an expression can do. If you need to automate other aspects of your project, like everything we listed here, then you need to learn writing scripts in After Effects instead of expressions, because all of this can be done with scripting. Okay, that's the end of the first part of our expressions course. Now you've got a general idea what expressions are and what you can or cannot do with them. In the next part, you're going to start writing your own expressions code. But don't be scared, you don't need to know anything about programming, and it will be easier than you think. If you can't wait to see the next part, please subscribe to our newsletter at mamoworld.com/subscribe. Because in the newsletter, we share all new tutorials already before they are published on the website. Again, this is Matthias Möhl for mamoworld.com. See you in the next part.